United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, we'll start with roll call. Gernwell? Myers?
Here.
Rushmore?
Here.
Imhoff?
Here.
Clark Hubbard here. Agenda, everybody should have had a copy of that. Any changes or additions to the agenda? I would just make one reordering. I think we'll do this permanently going forward if I remember to do it, but moving the zoning administrator report up to the top of other reports so Dave can give his report and then make it to Maple Valley. So we'll just move the fire district to the end going forward. Or actually, we'll move that after planning commission. Fire district after planning commission. And that moves zoning administrator and planning commission up. As far as you're gonna report on.
Yeah.
Yeah, just part of your report. So I make a motion that we approve the agenda, moving fire district below planning commission. Is there support? Support. Motion has been made and supported. Is there further discussion? Hearing none. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion passes. Minutes from the last meeting, September 9th. Everybody should have a chance to look those over. Is there any corrections or changes to the minutes?
Well, she's, Phil Morrow, you've got his name spelled wrong here at the bottom. That's everything I saw.
That's the only thing.
Yeah. Yep. So.
One thing I did want to add, under township assessor position where it says satisfactory check with position, can we just make that background check?
Right here.
Right. We want to say satisfactory background check.
Satisfactory background.
Anybody else have anything they noticed? So I'll make a motion that we approve the minutes as presented with the correction to the spelling of Phil Morrow's name and adding the word background in the township assessor section. Is there support on that?
Support.
Motion's been made and supported. Is there further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion passes. Public comment on agenda items. So we'll open it up 3 minutes for anything that is on the agenda, and then we'll have a public comment at the end for any topic. Does anybody have any comments on agenda? Okay, we'll go ahead and close that public comment session and move right into the treasurer's report with Dutch.
Okay, I'll read off everything like I usually do. I think I'll leave the cents off just for
sure.
Yeah. So the township general fund beginning balance $390,179, income $35,532, expenses $43,858, with an ending balance of $381,852. The fire district beginning balance $58,957, income of $5.74, interest. We paid them their second half of the year invoice of $51,347 with an ending balance of $7,616. Honeymoon Height Lights beginning balance $11,657 with income interest of $1.45, ending balance $11,659. CDs, we have two CDs. We did get our interest approved for the end of the third quarter. Beginning balance of $114,076, interest of $1,545, ending balance of $115,622. The tax account at the credit union, beginning balance of $143,525, income of $1,442,685. Checks written out paid is $1,514,439, ending balance of $71,771. I did pay to the township general fund for the SET from collecting the school taxes or the administration fee, $26,566. I did that on October 7th.
Mm-hmm.
And just another quick note going forward, at the end of really the first week of October, we had a total of 405 unpaid tax parcels. Of those 405, 93 of them were deferred, which leaves a total of 312 total parcels not yet paid, for a total of, including interest, about $223,000.
Left to collect.
Left to collect. We've had a half a dozen or so paid in the last week or so, but that's, yeah.
So those are all accruing interest now?
Yes.
And they have up until March, or February 28th to pay them before it gets turned over to the county?
Correct.
And we'll get the township's portion?
Correct.
Paid to us?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, and quick note on the fire district. So we're kind of researching how that flow of funds works, you know, why we can't just collect that like we do for every other taxing unit and pass that along, why we have to wait to be invoiced. So we're kind of researching that. So I hope to have more. It's just, you know, why do we hold on to the money when it belongs? You know, it's a millage that goes to the fire district. So hopefully more to come on that in the future. But anybody else have any questions for Dutch on the treasurer's report? Is there a motion to approve the treasurer's report?
I make a motion to approve the treasurer's report.
Is there support on that?
I'll support it.
Motion's been made and supported to approve the treasurer's report. Further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion passes. And then real quick, just an update on our banking. So Dutch and I, and Deputy Treasurer Jamie, met with Michelle Archibald, she's the CFO at the credit union, to talk about excess share coverage that they've now gotten in place for our accounts. When we're over that NCUA insurance limit, that we will have extra insurance, so we did meet with them to talk about that. And next month, our CDs mature, I think on Black Friday, and we had originally talked about swapping all of checking accounts to credit union, which all but the general fund has been moved, and then moving the CDs. But Dutch has also been doing a lot of legwork investigating CD rates.
CD rates, money market rates.
Money market.
Right. And we've reached out to Mercantile to meet with them. We've met with the credit union, so I'm hoping to meet with Mercantile maybe this week and just get more, because they have something similar to that, you know, where your funds are protected with $250,000. So, and we let the credit union know, first priority is security of your money, the safety of your money, then we go to interest rates. So once we know everything's secure, then we want to get the most interest
and
on our money.
The credit union didn't know what their Black Friday CD rate's going to be yet. So I guess we're kind of trying to see what's the best option for the township at this. So
yeah,
hopefully more in November.
Yeah, because we carry a lot of money in our general fund, so we might as well put that someplace makes some interest on it.
Yep.
So.
Yep. Okay. All right. We're moving into the clerk's report. First thing would be approval of the September bills. So Ginger has a nice printout here for us for monthly bill detail as of October 14th, today's meeting. A few items of note, all of our road work is now complete and all of the invoices are on here. There should be a big one here. It's on the back reverse side is our big Satterley Road invoice. But in total, I think our road work came in like $5,000 less than budget, which is great. We can use that money elsewhere if we move it around. One thing to note, it's like the check number 15316 to the View Group. It says $257.95. That's actually $20 too high. I was looking at that again. I caught that we actually got charged for an affidavit of publishing on something that we didn't get. So I called them and they were great and just said, yep, we'll credit your account. But we'll be getting another bill from them here when we have to do our notice of public hearing for this upcoming Lake Residential Ordinance. So I think we'll just go ahead and issue the check and we'll get our $20. So we're incurring that expense. Basically, it's going over them to them. I just got the thing. It'll be emailed over to them in the morning. So so anybody have any questions? there a motion to approve the October bill listing in the amount of $127,060.84?
I make a motion to approve the bills for the $127,060 as listed.
Is there support on that? Motion has been made and supported. That was David. Further discussion? Hearing none, we'll do roll call. Myers?
Yes.
Rushmore?
Yes.
Imhoff?
Yes.
Bernwald?
Yes.
Clark Hubbard, yes. Motion carries. Okay. You may have noticed it might be a little chilly in here today. There's a couple little oscillating fans because we're trying to circulate heat. The furnace in the office, or the furnace that feeds the office, is working. The furnace out here is not kicking on. So we had talked about getting it inspected anyway. So I was actually already had called on that this morning, and then came in here and figured the furnace is not working. So we need to have somebody out here, hopefully this week, to figure out what's going on. It does not appear the pilot is lit. Hopefully it's just a quick fix, but we still need it inspected. It's an older unit. So I called Sunrise Heating and Plumbing out of Greenville. They are $102 per hour with a minimum 1 hour charge. That's when they leave the shop, and when they get back to the shop, they're on the clock. Any parts or materials, labor for whatever, if it does need some service work, would be separate, and they would get it. They would tell us first. They wouldn't just do the work. They can do this Thursday from noon to 2. I also called Custom Plumbing and Heating out of Mount Pleasant. They're a little more pricier, $115 for the first half hour, and then $100 per hour plus travel. They could do Thursday or Friday. I also called Russell Plumbing and Heating out of Greenville. They were a $99 inspection fee, but they can't get us in until November. Parker Arntz was $105 per hour, and they did not return my call on timing. So we need to get this furnace going. I would like to make a motion to hire Sunrise Heating and Plumbing to perform the furnace inspection at the $102 an hour. And then, because we don't know if this needs some repair, and we have it in our budget for repair, I would like to approve, obviously they need to talk to us first, but approve an amount, up to amount for them to do repairs, so we don't have to call a special meeting if it's, to come back if it's $400, if it's $500. I guess to be safe, would we say approve repair work up to $1,000?
That's money, yes.
I just wanted to be safe, That way, they would talk to me first,
yes.
If they were, if it was something I didn't feel comfortable with, we could call a special meeting. But so just to restate, I guess, that motion to hire Sunrise Heating and Plumbing to perform the inspection at $102 an hour and perform any necessary repair work.
Randy, what about cleaning the machines too? I mean, like a yearly maintenance thing? Should we consider on maybe that could be after the fact or something?
Yeah, let's see what we got. I mean, we don't even really know how old it is. Right. Nobody really knows.
Who was the last time it was maintained?
When it was last maintained, when it was installed. Okay. And they're going to look at it and inspect it and then obviously tell us what it's going to take to get it
running. And that might be part of their bid too, when they tell you that they're going to inspect it and just tell it.
Yeah,
okay.
Okay, it's not working because of this, but right. By the way, this is going to be going bad here soon.
Right.
That type of thing. That way we'd be kind of covered.
Right.
Up to $1,000 was the last part of that.
Yeah.
Okay, I think there was a rental on Sunday, so I guess if you hear from them, let me know.
Yeah.
I think there's a rental next Sunday.
Well, yeah,
Sunday.
If they come out this Thursday, which we do in
two,
they would hopefully be able to fix it.
Yeah.
Get it going. And then, that rental.
Yeah, sometimes you're waiting on parts and stuff, so.
Yeah.
Okay, so let me know if we,
Yep,
I will.
Is there support on that motion?
Support.
Okay, that's a leader to it. Motion's been made and supported. Is there further discussion? First, expended money, so we'll do roll call. Bernwald?
Yes.
Clark Hubbard, yes. Imhoff?
Yes.
Rushmore?
Yes.
Myers?
Yes.
All right, motion passes. Just also of note, we are revisiting the generator hookup options and kind of making some phone calls on that, getting with what Marcy had originally looked at. We talked about a portable generator, getting a hookup set for that, but there's a few other variables we need to think about, so stay tuned on that.
Maybe you can remember how our election.
That is, I'm getting there.
Okay, I didn't see that.
Yep, it's.
You got it.
I've been doing all the talking and clerk support.
That's fine, that's why I just didn't want you to forget me.
No.
Forget that.
We won't go through this in detail, but next month, we might maybe look at a few line adjustments, but in your materials, you have general fund budget to actual through September 30th, which is through the account that I'll reconcile through the first quarter, and fire fund in Honeymoon Heights, so look that over. You'll notice the road savings where we could maybe, I'd like to potentially reallocate that since it's not, we don't have a road millage, so what we spend on roads is just not a general allocated money. We can reallocate that somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, we are incurring a fair amount of legal fees with the zoning work that we're doing. Also, we've been working with Lane on accounting, so maybe we can reallocate those funds, but just, you know, kind of look that over for next month, and we can go from there. But just wanted to let you know you had that, and then I was going to let Ginger go ahead and talk about the election update, and yes, I did have on there to talk about worker pay, so.
So you want me to ask anybody?
Do you want me to?
No.
I can. I have my little bullet points.
No, we had our election commission meeting Friday afternoon, and during that meeting, I made a motion that we raise the pay for our election inspectors for several reasons. But one of the reasons was that, and I didn't bring that with me, but I have a chart if anybody'd like to see it. The average pay, the high pay in Michigan is about $27 an hour. The average pay is $22 an hour. And we, just the last time, went up to $15 an hour. We were paying $12. And we knew that we were the lowest pretty much in the area. But I have the best workers possible. Elections are so important, especially now. And trust me, I just been working like crazy, and I know that they're going to be working like crazy come too, and they're worth it, and I want to keep them that way. So I made a motion that we, with board approval, pay our election inspectors $20 an hour, and we will have one chairperson, and that person will be $25 an hour. The 27 for Michigan, that's for the workers, and I'm not real sure. I can't remember what the chairperson made, but usually about $5.
So you had made that, brought that up at our election commission meeting,
yes,
which is Dutch, you, and myself,
right,
and we voted in favor to recommend that to the board, to the full board, for approval. And yeah, I mean, we've always been way low. We upped it at this latest budget cycle, and we're still lower than you. You also contacted several other townships,
yes,
around us, and we're the lowest of them.
And Maple Valley, that's what Maple Valley is paying, now that we have to be like any other township, but I like to compare, you know, what the other ones are making, and they're worth it. I don't care, you know, it's definitely not paying,
yeah,
them too much. They're trained, they know what they're doing, I can trust them. I can't be out on the floor even, so to me, it's definitely worth it. I would give my pay.
So we budgeted a total of $5,000 for election worker wages, and through today, because there obviously hasn't been any elections since August, we are at $16.25.75. So we've got plenty of room in our budget, I think, to increase that. And then, if possible, we will be having May or February?
January
election for Lakeview Community Schools, who did not get their millage, operating millage on the ballot for
a special election, but they have to pay for the, our cost. So we that shouldn't affect.
Yes, yes, they have to pay all costs.
So, so I think just what I'm saying is for the two elections we'll have in this fiscal year, we should have plenty. They're there for what, from 6 a.m. to 9 p.m. It's a long day, you know, so 15 hours minimum. But some people only work half days too.
Yeah, no, we have one job that they split it.
Okay, so.
So did you consider the average of 22 versus the 20?
Say that again.
Did you consider maybe the average amount of 22 versus 20?
I had, I was thrilled with 20, I guess I wasn't.
Yeah.
But I think that's
good.
I think that's good for now. And the 22, the average, they're averaging in cities where they have
a larger
people.
Okay, that makes sense.
But this election just seems to really, I mean, I've been working like crazy trying to keep up with it. And people are a little testy now too, you know, and I mean, they're nervous and they don't know what to believe and what to trust. And so we have to do our best to be our best.
I'm going to go ahead and make a motion that we increase the election inspector pay from $15 to $20 effective for the November election. And also increase the election chairperson pay from $17 to $25 to put it in line with market pay. Is there support for that?
I'll support.
Motion's been made and supported. Is there further discussion? Hearing none, we'll do roll call. Myers?
Yes.
Rushmore?
Yes.
Imhoff?
Yes.
Clark Hubbard? Yes. Bernwald?
Yes.
Motion passes. Okay, moving into Dave on the zoning administrator's report.
Okay, for the month of September, there's 8450 Tamarack Road, a 12 by 20 shed. And there's a list of complaints for violation at 6100 Cutler. A neighbor was saying they were staying there for quite a bit of a time, but they do have 14 days, and he said he can't confirm that it's been 14 days yet, so I'm waiting. I heard they moved it off. They might try and bring him back. I don't know. Yeah, 11589 Juniper. Okay, light. That's the fourth ticket I issued. When I went in to issue this ticket, I talked to the clerk in the courthouse, and they said they didn't have any record of the past tickets. I don't know what happened. They filed that, maybe shoved behind a file cabinet or something, but I have my part. But anyway, that's, I guess that's considered the first one, but on the ticket I put the fourth one. Okay, at, okay, what was that? That was one on Juniper. Okay, at 6002 Honeymoon Drive. The unplated car, and they say it's not running. Well, it was backed up real tight against the garage, and I couldn't prove it wasn't running, or couldn't prove there were no plates on it. So I have to let that one go. On 11381 Hickory, they said there's an old camper and no license plate on that. I can't confirm that. I can't trespass on their property legally, and I'm not going to do it any other way. And so I let that one go. And 11700 Cherry, and that the neighbors, somebody complained he's cutting down the neighbor's tree. It's an empty lot. We don't regulate that, and they said he's in the camper for 14 days. Send him a notice. He called me back, and I need to get out there this week, and supposedly he's going to get it out of there. Yeah, 6079 Pine Light. I sent the notice. Now it's time for me to write a ticket out for them. And 6541 Schmid, complaint that light, there's boat and canopy on the lake. It's on Schmid, and I sent the letter back to the complainant saying that we don't regulate the water. there was a blight in the driveway, and I drove by there a little while back, days ago, and it is picked up. There wasn't much there, but blight is blight, I guess. At 11709, I misspelled cherry. That's cherry. And there's blight there, and that's usually once or twice a year. They accumulate blight.
And as far as this goes, our process, you know, obviously we don't disclose who the complaints are, but Dave's getting, we get these complaints, and you send a notice, mm-hmm. Hey, you got 30 days, please clean it up. Try to work with them first.
Yeah.
And then we have to write a ticket later. So you try to work with people, you know, versus.
What's the process of writing the ticket? You said you take it to the clerk over there then?
To the courthouse.
To the courthouse.
I file it with them.
Yeah. Okay, and you file it with them. And then where does it go?
I just wait and around about a month later, it could be sooner or later, I get a summons up here in court, and the person that it was written out to mm-hmm. receives a summons too. And I usually go there lately, since the COVID, a lot of people do that Zoom or whatever, mm-hmm. They don't show up there. But sometimes they do. The other day, somebody showed up there, I'm surprised. But then the magistrate listens to it, and you know, usually it's pretty obvious for blight. You know, there's
right.
other things I go there for too, though. But,
yeah, we do try to work with people, and as always, you know,
yeah.
your
oh,
safe
yeah.
your safety first, Dave. If ever you feel, you know, I know you said you've got some nasty calls and stuff, but we don't want you putting yourself in jeopardy. So we'll
yeah.
just keep the communication open
yep.
and file a police report if somebody's harassing
yeah.
you. We definitely want keep your safety first. Any other questions for Dave on
yeah.
zoning?
So Dave, you said that you don't, there's a complaint that there's like a vanity car not running or unplated. You don't go to, how do you verify? I mean.
I can walk legally without being charged for trespassing. I can walk on a designated driveway or walkway, and that's it, but I can't even set one foot in the grass. That's trespassing.
You can go in their driveway.
Or their walk sidewalk going to their house.
And
I was
make
told
it
by the MTA that it's the Girl Scout rule. You can go up and you can knock on the door, and then you walk
yeah.
out the same way you walked in. You know?
Yeah.
So it is kind of a you know
right.
a fine.
Like this car that's backed up there, they were super close, and
sure.
I'm not even going to lean over on their car or touch their building. I'm
yeah.
kind of careful.
Is honest. There a way you can write them at least a letter? In regards to, there was a complaint.
I could, yeah.
Yeah, write him a letter. There was a complaint. And obviously, you cannot verify what you would like, but maybe to contact you to give you more information.
Yep. I can.
Yeah.
Could do that.
That's a good
that's
idea.
A, that's a very good idea, yeah.
That way, at least the complainer knows that you are doing your due diligence.
Yeah. Yep.
Okay, thank you, Dave. Marcy, anything on land divisions?
We had one property combination. So, which I approved that, and I'm working on a couple different, one right now that I'm actually going to go look at tomorrow. A few years ago, it was a residential home that they lived in, they bought the next door neighbors, and then they combined all the lots together, so I got two residential homes on one property number, and now they want to sell them, so they want to split them again. So I'm going to go look at that because I don't think it's going to, the properties are too close to the property lines, but that's a request from Lane Levy. He's the one listing, so he's agreed to meet me out there tomorrow. So I'm going to go look at that tomorrow. And then another one that I am actually working on with Dave, and we're trying to figure some things out on this other one.
Okay.
Yes. So it got a little busy this one.
All right. Thank you. And you got it.
Yep.
Thanks, Dave.
Yep.
Okay, moving into planning commission report.
We need to figure out for recording secretary. Jenny.
You're no longer recording
Jenny,
secretary.
Jenny,
none of the board
members. Nope, I asked him last meeting, and Jake said he'd do it until we found somebody, but he did not want to do that. And then Phil's position, he resigned in December.
Phil
is not renewing, he's not going for a new term.
The chairman position. So we're gonna have to figure out what we're gonna do there. We need a better map for zoning to follow, because it, I mean, we have a, basically a blanket one, but it doesn't, you can't see each lot and add them up. We figured that out with going through this one. We talked, you talked to Danielle and we'll figure that out. The Lake Residential public hearing is for November 13th. We have it done and we'll go through that and bring it back to the board.
Yeah, I got the notice, I have, Phil, Leslie emailed Phil, copied me with the notice to get in the paper. So we'll get that going in case that.
Okay, and then, wind, solar, battery, we can.
New business.
Yeah, good.
Couple things, on that Lake Residential ordinance, I really haven't looked at anything, we'll get the drafts posted on the website, obviously, ahead of the public hearing. But how does the map get, we're creating a new zoning district. How do we, our map doesn't have it, but what properties are in it, is that part of what she's got?
That's what she's supposed to, yeah, have it, because she had it drawn in there on the new master plan, but that's why it needs to be.
Okay, that's.
Boy, I mean, it's so small.
So there'll be a new map that shows the boundaries of this new lake, and that's only gonna be a town line, it's not gonna cover like Lake Forest?
It should be all.
It's gonna cover Lake Forest?
It should be any of them.
Or Tamarack on the one side, okay.
That's what, I mean, we haven't talked about the map as far as us, and that's what, why we're asking her to make sure what she's doing, the commercial, that she has it all.
Okay.
Now that we have it going.
And then just one other thing, I'll add, I did get a call, today with some concerns on accessory building height. If you remember, 2 years ago or so now, we had upped it from 14 to 18 foot. And, I know even after that, there was people who wanted to, build something higher. So just a heads up, that might be something that's coming to you guys, of, you might be getting a request to revisit that, I guess, so I just wanted to let you know that.
And I know when the, this gets approved, they'll have to come back, the township board will have to figure out for permit requirement for the permit fee set by the township board.
For.
For can, separate camping permit.
Because the Lake Residential will have a camping.
Yeah.
Address all the camping concerns.
Yes, and it's a listed, I think she did a very well job.
Okay.
What we want to offer, so.
All right, any questions for Dave on planning commission? Go along. Fire district, so, normally Ginger would give that report, but she was not able to attend, the meeting due to illness. So I attended last, what, was it last Thursday or 2 weeks ago Thursday, I don't remember. So I'll just give a quick report, so they did get a new tender, in, they ordered two new